I bought my first Chinese mobile phone. Well, nowadays everything is made in China, but this is Xiaomi's Redmi Note 9. I was a little scared about all the talk about excessive bloatware and ads, but we will deal with that together. This is how Redmi Note 9 looks right out of a box. Only two screens and very nice app drawer, which is divided into several sections for easier use. This app drawer is a new thing in MIUI 12. All I did up to this point is an upgrade to MIUI version 12. And as you can see, it takes up 19 GB of space. There should be some apps I can uninstall from the app drawer, and let's try to do that. And yes, I can uninstall many apps, mostly games. The phone came with 306 apps, and as you might have noticed, they are nowhere near that number in the app drawer. If I try to uninstall some more stubborn apps like Mi Video or Mi Browser, I will not be able to do that from here. To do that, I must enable USB debugging. To enable it, I will go into Settings, and here where it says About Phone. Now, I must tap like crazy on MIUI version until developer options become available. Now, go back and into additional settings. Tap here on developer options and down here turn on USB debugging. I must wait a little and accept. Now you will need computer and two pieces of free software. First is Xiaomi's ADB Fastboot tools. Just go to this page and download jar file. Link is in the description. For the second software, I knew I needed Java. So I came to this page and downloaded the latest Java. After installing Java and connecting my phone to my laptop, I wasn't able to start Fastboot tool. After a long while, I discovered that I needed something called Java Development Kit. I have put links to the Windows and Mac versions of that, so you can download it and install it, without making Oracle account. When you have done that, connect your phone to your computer and start Xiaomi's ADB Fastboot tools. Here is everything what is on my phone. Let's uninstall Mi Browser as a test run. I have never done this before. It says it's done. So let's check the Redmi Note 9. Here I am in the app drawer again, and Mi Browser is gone. It was right here between Messages and Mi Remote. Great, I will go back to the Debloat software. Now, I did some research to find out what is safe to remove and what is not safe to remove. For this first run, I have chosen 11-12 apps I will remove. I will keep this on the screen a little longer so you can see what I am uninstalling. It is possible that I will remove more later, but this is it for now. This MSA app is in charge of the all Xiaomi ads, so you definitely should remove that. Good, the phone is still working. Let me show you what to do about notifications and recommendations. Xiaomi Redmi phones love to offer. Notifications you can disable in the Settings app, one app at a time. It is the same like on any other Android phone. As for the recommendations, you should open one app at a time and disable it. For example, this Mi Video app, if you still have it. Just go to the settings of each app and disable, in this case, push notifications. Somewhere it is called recommendations, but it is the same thing. At the end, what I got is clean looking phone with only stuff I want here. If you would like to see how I got this cool looking wallpaper on the locked screen and on the unlocked phone, let me know in the comments just before you like this video and subscribe to my channel.